美国国务院7月7日谴责海地总统莫伊泽在家中被暗杀，并且升级妻子马蒂娜的事件。53岁的莫伊兹在他的私人住宅中被身份不明的持枪歹徒开枪打死，他的妻子受伤。这一事件在这个贫困的加勒比国家引发了人们对混乱的担忧。这个国家已经受到了猖獗的帮派暴力的打击，并且面临着一场宪法危机。海地驻美国大使埃德蒙在接受采访时表示，海地政府希望美国在暗杀事件发生之后提供安全援助。埃德蒙表示，持枪歹徒谎称自己是美国缉毒局的特工，并且引用了政府的视频，但是他补充说，他不相信他们是缉毒局的特工。美国国务院发言人普莱斯表示，有关袭击者是缉毒局特工的报告绝对是错误的。普莱斯在每日的新闻发布会上表示，在援助方面，他没有要宣布的最新消息，不过华盛顿准备对请求做出回应，并且准备支持海地当局的调查。
I obviously want to start with the situation in Haiti. And the United States strongly condemns, as you heard from President Biden earlier today, the assassination of President Jovenel Moise and the attack on First Lady Martine Moise in Haiti. We extend our deepest condolences to President Moise's family and his loved ones and to the people of Haiti in the midst of this tragedy.Those who seek to accomplish their political goals through violence and by subverting the rule of law will not succeed in thwarting the Haitian people and their desire for a better, for a brighter future. We urge Haitian authorities to bring those responsible to justice. We have made very clear to Haitian authorities that the United States is standing ready to provide assistance, and we are prepared to provide any and all forms of appropriate assistance to our Haitian partners.
Can you say that that's not the case, that you have an assessment that those are not the officials? Can you sort of, you know, set the record straight on?
These reports are absolutely false. The United States condemns this heinous act. These false reports are nothing more than that, just false reports.
海地反对派指责美国对莫伊兹过于宽容，因为他支持美国的外交政策。美国是海地最大的外国捐助国。莫伊兹曾经因为腐败指控、对经济的管理和对权力的日益控制而面临辞职呼声和大规模抗议。1994年，华盛顿向海地派遣了军队，推翻了军政府，并且让民选总统、前教区牧师让·贝特朗·阿里斯蒂德重新掌权。自那以后，这个国家一直在与政治不稳定和一系列自然灾害做斗争。自那之后，美国政府减少了对海地的干预，联合国维和行动于2019年结束。